We Boca TV is the first 24-hour digital broadcast network dedicated to all the amazing things that Boca Raton has to offer. Wake up and go every week with Good Morning Boca, hosted by Chris Cruz and Kelly Gannon. Watch as Kelly and Chris will be traveling around town interviewing business owners, celebrities, newcomers, and checking out all the new local hotspots.
Welcome back to Good Morning Boca. I am Kelly Gannon alongside
Chris Cruz.
And we have a great show coming up for you guys today. We are talking to the newest magazine here in Boca and the man who calls himself the Talk Whisperer.
So grab a glass of coffee, grab some juice, raw juice, whatever you do best, whatever makes you feel good. Good Morning Boca starts right after this.
Coming up next, creative director of JMW Florida Properties, Mary Widmer.
Good morning, Boca. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We got a great show ahead of us. My name is Chris Cruz.
I'm Kelly Gannon. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning, Kelly. Boca. And good morning, Boca. Hope you guys got your coffee, your energy drink, your green thing in a cup. This is how we do it, because that's how Boca is. We're going to get some amazing people we're going to talk to. Who loves a beautiful home on the water?
I love a beautiful home on the water.
I love beautiful homes on the water. We got a very special person hanging out with us today. We're gonna talk about some million-dollar homes. She breaks them down, she builds them up, and she makes them spectacular. Please welcome Mary Widmer, creative director.
JMW Florida Properties.
Welcome
to the show.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Nice to have you. So tell us about these spectacular homes. We saw some of the photos, and we see that you're just taking these magnificent properties, and you're making them even,
Taking them down
and bringing them back up.
Picking great locations and building up masterpieces in their place. So how's the process work?
Well, the process works very simply. You try to find a piece of property that you think that's for sale, for one thing. And then you try to take that property and remove what's there and build something that's more enhancing, more beautiful on the water than what's currently there. So I take an older home and tear it down, and then work closely with the architect to begin putting a new home together.
Sounds exciting.
It does sound exciting.
And fun.
So Mary, what it sort of inspires or drives your creative direction with the property?
Well, being in South Florida, it's very, very important to me that you incorporate the surroundings. What inspires me is the immediacy to the ocean. The intercoastal waterway, all the beautiful tropical vegetation. All of those things I try to incorporate in some fashion into my home.
So let me ask you a question. So that you're putting all that together, you're basing it on the environment. What's your favorite part of the process? When you're taking this home, you find the property, you're doing the development, the architecture, the east side, the west side. What's your favorite? Is it at the end result when you can open that door and say, wow, this is what I built?
Actually, for me, it's the process.
The whole process.
It's the entire process. I love planning and drawing and preparing and getting together all of the plans. And then what's really exciting is after they drive all those pilings into the ground, which under my last house was 135 pilings, 39 feet into the ground, that incorporate the base for the house, the pool deck, the pool. Once they get all that in and you get your slab on those pilings, then the fun begins for me.
Well, the homes that you do, you know, when we were talking earlier, are such a large scale. They're not, you know, you're a 2,000, 3,000 square foot home. You're talking very large scale homes and doing massive, massive projects with, you know, huge amounts of pilings and, you know, great locations. How did you get started in doing things in such a large scale? Because that's really what your homes reflect.
Well, the house that I built up north was 7,500 square feet, plus it was a three-story from the back, which had a complete finished basement, so really it was more like 12,000 square feet. And I did that 20 years ago. So it's been one of those situations where either go big or go home.
Right? That's a great way.
I'm messing around.
So if somebody wants to go see some of the homes that you've built, where can they actually see them?
They can see them on my website at www.jmwfloridaproperties.com.
And do you have anything currently on the market?
Yes, with Douglas Elliman, my real estate agent is Chad Carroll, my representative, and Michael Predatory. And there's two in Highland Beach right now I have for sale, in Bellito Isle, and there's one in Boca Raton on Enfield. And they're all for sale right now.
So if we're looking to have a house party, we're going to go see
her.
We're
now, so.
More information, check it all out on the website. Mary, thank you so much for stopping on by. We have so much more on the way right here on Good Morning Boca. Stay close.
Did you know that a healthy, beautiful smile is one of the keys to good overall health? New research shows that the health of your mouth reflects the health of your entire body. This includes whether or not you may be at risk of developing a chronic disease, such as heart disease, kidney disease, or oral cancer. Poor oral health may even cause some of these health problems to occur. Research also shows that good oral health can actually prevent certain diseases from developing. Are you taking steps to ensure that you have a beautiful smile, like brushing at least twice a day with fluoride toothpaste, flossing, and scheduling regular dental cleanings? Good oral hygiene enhances your beautiful smile, and scheduling regular dental visits can help you prevent or even discover health problems at an early age. Hot off the press, Boca has a new magazine in town, and we will be interviewing the publisher and founders, Jerry and Lucy Spielman, talking about how to find all the latest happenings around town.
Please welcome to the show, editor and publisher, Jerry and Lucy Spielman.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. Good morning. Did you have your green stuff in a cup? Okay, good.
All right, so you're feeling like I'm ready to go?
So we're super excited. The talk of the town, Boca's best magazine. So let's talk about this magazine and why it is the talk of Boca.
Well, we decided that the magazines in Boca, while they're very beautiful and they're great, they only cater to the very super luxurious and wealthy people.
Well, there's a lot of those here in Boca.
There are some not so luxurious people.
I get it.
There's a lot of other advertisers and clients who want to be in the magazines or want to get their products and services known to the public community. And I think the 300-page magazines are just too thick. There's a thing called ad fatigue. And most people pick up a magazine, and after 100 pages, they put it down and never pick it up. Plus, they don't remember what they just read. We try to have, my group has three actual magazines, and they're all individual for each community. We love Boca Raton, we love the charitable feeling that we have with all the people, what they do for the community, and we also love our clients. We actually enjoy doing the magazine, and we love what we're able to do.
So in addition to having a reduced length for better retention, what can readers expect to see each month in the magazine?
We have different sections. We have a pet section, which is wonderful.
Which I love. I saw that.
We have legal advice. We have healthy tips and a calendar with events.
Oh, that's fantastic. So.
But I like the fact that it's just very specific and to the point, which is good. Because like, you know, when I go to, especially like a restaurant, I want to keep it like simple, short and sweet. Yeah. No, that's why it's called Boca's Best.
It is. It's just the best of the best.
So where do you circulate this? Is it delivered to a certain amount of homes, or is this like at different business locations that you could find it?
Okay. We actually made a hybrid model.
Okay.
We mail out 25,000 magazines.
Wow, it's a lot.
We also provide.
Is that proof, East Boca or West Boca?
East and West Boca. Okay. It provides actual proof of mailings. If somebody says they do 25,000, they should show you a receipt that shows 25,000. Mm-hmm. And we do that. We just started leaving it at certain locations throughout Boca, maybe 10 or 15 locations, which next month we're going to actually list the locations.
Okay.
We don't believe that leaving 50 magazines at every store is very effective.
Makes sense, yeah.
People don't really read them. They get messy and get thrown out. And we like what we do very much. We're at a lot of functions. I'm sponsoring the Boca Festival of the Arts, the Boca Italian Fest, and we're handing out hundreds, if not thousands, more magazines at these events.
What are some of the other charity events that you guys are involved in or charity information you can get in the magazine?
We just happened to join the Rotary group in Boca. I joined 4 months ago. Lucy joined 2 weeks ago. She hated to be N1, so now she's a Rotarian as well. We do a lot of charity events, and I just actually invented a special new charity idea that I think is just unbelievable, especially for Boca. It's called an online charity trading post exchange.
Different businesses?
What happened was I bought 30 boxes of clothing to donate to kids, new kids. And the boxes did not have what they said they had on it. A lady was looking for the Broward School District for kids that taken away from abusive homes, and they wanted the blankets. I was speaking to some lady from JAFCO, and she had 50 blankets and pillows extra that she didn't need. So mm-hmm. I put them together, and there's so much out there that people have and don't need, charity groups and businesses, that there's no one place out there that you could...
That you can process everything through.
That's great. So where can people go to get that information? Because I think that's great when sure. charity is a surplus, but somebody else has a need.
We have a new media group with a new, brand new responsive website.
Okay. And what's the website?
BBCNmediagroup.com, Boca's Best City News Mediagroup.com. Also, Boca's Best Magazine gets you there. In about 2 months, I hope to have the Trading Post working. I have one gentleman that has a whole truckload of wheelchairs and walkers and canes. That's my first product on the donation side.
That's fantastic. Well, so for more information for the newest magazine in town and that are doing wonderful charity things as well, check out Boca's Best Magazine at either that will show up at your door or
BocasBestMagazine.com.
Thank you
guys for stopping by. We have so many more exciting things in the Talk Whisperer coming up in just a few minutes. Stay close.
With internet TV and streaming ever growing in popularity, so are your choices. BYL Network is a multi-channel broadcast network featuring on-demand smart TV programming to motivate, educate, and entertain millions of people around the world. BYL Network features the best of real people, real solutions, and real life, while giving you plenty of real good viewing options. BYL Network, better your life. Start streaming, uploading, and sharing for free today online at BYLnetwork.com.
In 1911, Douglas Elliman and his brother Roland opened Douglas L. Elliman & Company at 421 Madison Avenue. The company was founded on Elliman's vision that New Yorkers would shift their preference of traditional homes to favor luxury apartments that were both sold and managed by comprehensive real estate companies. 100 years later, Douglas Elliman is now the leader within the New York real estate market, the top firm in Miami Beach, and the fastest growing brokerage in South Florida. Our philosophy at Douglas Elliman is simple. We respond to the desire of our clients, and the desire for South Florida has never been stronger. In the past year, Douglas Elliman's Florida brokerage has expanded its footprint to more than 19 offices through Miami, Miami Beach, Coconut Grove, Bay Harbor, Aventura, Fort Lauderdale, Boca Raton, Delray Beach, Palm Beach, Wellington, and Jupiter. The numbers we have achieved speak for themselves. Over 875 agents have generated more than 2,000 total transactions in 2016, representing $2.4 billion in sales. As Manhattan's top firm, we have a profound understanding of the ties that bind South Florida to the New York region, and we're better positioned than anyone to ensure that relationship benefits our clients. With recent domestic expansion into Los Angeles, Aspen, and Greenwich, the Elliman Network has never been stronger in the key markets that serve our clientele. Now allied with London-based Knight Frank Residential, the largest privately owned property consultancy in the world, the Douglas Elliman influence extends globally to 6 continents, 58 countries, and a luxury network of millions, exposing our clients to a global database of prospective buyers across the world. No other firm can match our presence, knowledge, reach, or expertise. Let the power of Elliman work for you.
You've heard of ghost whispers and dog whispers. How about talk whispers? Let's meet one right now. Hello, Corey Baker.
Good morning, Boca. I am Kelly Gannon alongside the one and only
Chris Cruz.
We are here today at Boca West Country Club right here in Boca Raton, Florida, and have a really exciting show coming up. But so far, I've been having a great day so far.
Great morning so far.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes.
It's still morning.
She forgets because we start so early in the morning.
And it's a lot of caffeine. It feels like I've had a day already.
So I'm super excited. Have you heard of the Ghost Whisperer?
I've heard of the Ghost Whisperer.
I'm not big on ghosts, but the Dog Whisperer?
I've heard of the Dog Whisperer.
Have you heard of it? Apparently he's really good at what he does. Corey Baker's in the house. Good morning, Corey.
Good Good morning, guys.
It never gets old, does it?
It doesn't. Right? Actually, it doesn't.
It's actually
all
fun for us.
Same thing.
It's exciting.
Voicemail every meeting. Mm-hmm. So, all right, well, tell us what it means. Now.
Yeah. I know the ghost thing. I get the dog thing. I'm not sure about you yet.
Right. So, good example. The dog whisperer with Cesar Millan.
Yeah.
I was inspired by what he does and his name. Because a whisperer is an expert, right? So what Cesar is actually doing is he's not just dog training. He's not just commanding the dog. If you notice, if you've seen the show, so mm-hmm. he's looking at the body language. He's looking at the energy. He's extensively interviewing the owners. He's seeing their body language, what they're saying, what they're not saying. And he always talks about energy and the environment in which the animal and the owner are in and all this stuff, right? So if I compared myself to, like, you know, most coaches or therapists, or should I say coaches or therapists that focus on talk therapy, I am kind of taking in everything similar mm-hmm. to what the dog whisperer is doing. And maybe you didn't know, and for those of you out there that might not have known, so when we communicate interpersonally, it's composed of 93% nonverbal. So our communication exchange even right now is like, exactly, like I see his body language shifting. The body language and tone of voice is 93%. Only 7% is actually the words that we choose. So that is a lot of what I'm taking in to be able to give my client is the best feedback that I possibly can and
so
be able to get significant
clients?
Results.
Who are your clients? Is it
I feel nervous for some reason.
Did you feel like
he's watching my body language.
He's got somebody back there taking notes. You know, like we're going to get a little rundown later. So, but who is your client? Is it executives? Is it people that are going and making pitches? Salespeople? Who is it?
It is primarily now, yes.
Okay.
It is. Yeah, and I've worked across the board. I've worked with families. I've worked with couples. I have teen programs, things like this.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Yeah.
No, I think it's great. I think it's extremely important.
Yeah.
You'd be surprised when you really start to study the human personality.
Yeah.
You learn a lot from it.
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean,
so tell me what you're learning about Kelly this morning.
I don't know. I don't think everybody really wants to get the feedback.
So, right, like on the air. Like, I know it's all going to be good, so yeah, I'm not really worried about it.
My mother said, if you don't have something nice to say, don't say
wow.
it. At all. I'm just
right.
kidding. Yeah, just kidding, people.
Don't worry about it.
No, actually, she, tell you the truth. So her what we call micro expressions, her smile is gorgeous. She's just had a very generous, giving smile.
Yes, she does.
You know, if you compare aww. Different smiles, so that's
well,
actually
thanks,
that's
gentlemen.
Actually the truth.
So how do people find you? Do you find them? Like how does that happen?
Either or. Yeah.
So how do they know they need you?
Let's do that one first because I've got a follow-up question.
Yeah.
So how do they know they need you?
So good question. So, if they just know how I can help, basically. Ultimately what they want me for is they want, you know, especially with businesses, they want me so they can make more money and they can have a healthier work environment. And let me kind of give some perspective to problem. It may not be like the boss is a big jerk, right? It might be like what I would call an inefficiency. So let me give you an example. For instance, let's say you have a car, drives decent, but you take it in for a tune-up, you get it back, and you notice that it drives a lot better,
mm-hmm.
right? So similar to people in workplaces, they may get used to, you know, like tensions and miscommunications and just an unhealthy workplace, and they just adapt to it and they get used to it. So I kind of come in, I give a tune-up. I give feedback. I just try to make sure that it's a healthy environment and everybody's getting along really well.
So how does the process start? You come in and you observe, or you come in with recommendation, like sort of blanket recommendations, or?
Yeah, so I make it easy for them right off the bat. I come in, I give them an assessment, and, you know, initial interview with management. That reminds me, for any of you out there that are business owners that invite me in, for an assessment, I will be happy to offer a free one. So what I do is I'll come in, I'll have that brief little interview. Once they're feeling comfortable, they will give me permission to be able to confidentially and very briefly interview their employees. Once I kind of have an opportunity to do that, I can make a quick assessment and kind of see what is and what kind of program might be suitable for them and how I might be able to help. And so outside of the consulting and the feedback I might give, I have like a variety of team builders as well. Like all like learning more communication, conflict resolution related, and a doozy that everybody likes is managing stress and anxiety, which everybody could use at least.
Every day.
Yeah, exactly. Use a piece of. So ultimately what the goal is to just have like a well-oiled machine to make sure that it's a healthy environment. Everybody, you know, even if you have a fast pace, that everybody feels good about what's going on, and that way everybody feels, you know, comfortable coming back the next day. You know, simple as that.
All right, so if you want more on Corey, of course, he said he'll give you a free assessment if you're paying attention to his little speech earlier. You can find the information below or on the website. Corey, thank you so much for stopping by. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
I definitely want to chat with you a little bit more after this.
Happy to.
If you could fix him, that would be great.
Might be a big undertaking, but we'll give it a try. I mean, I'm just
everybody's
saying,
fixable. Some people just take longer than others.
Thank you for watching Good Morning Boca. Join us next week, same time, different place.
Stay tuned each week as we broadcast some amazing people, things to do, and what's happening all around town.
Super excited. We got the magazine so you guys can see it. It's the talk of the town. So we've been looking, breezing through it. Right. Tell us a little bit about the noise in the background.
Right. Not a little noise, but
close, ever so quietly.
Hi, I'm Nicole Ruth, publisher of Boca Life magazine. We're here in the best of downtown Delray Beach. We're going to be visiting all the stores, starting with Unique Boutique, and then working our way to the Seagate Hotel and Spa.
Hi, so good to see you.
Good morning, Nicole.
I love the store, Unique Boutique. It's like, if I'm going to go anywhere on the avenue, I'm going to come here. This is like your destination store. You have accessories, jewelry. Tell me everything you've got and what's going on this season.
Thank you so much. I love all the compliments. We have beautiful things for the season. Every week we get new things in from our clothing, our handbags, Mary Frances, her new clutch line that's fabulous. And of course, always Gabriel Ofeisch, my best-selling fabulous jewelry, the square rings that I wear and the ones that I advertise the most. I just want to tell you that we're so proud. We just celebrated 8 years on the avenue in lovely downtown Delray Beach. And this is our expansion from Naples and Cape Cod, so we're very proud to be here.
Karen, so how does one find you besides coming here on the avenue? What's the best way to come to the store and have the shopping experience and reach out to you?
Well, we'd love to have you visit our website, www.uniqueboutiquejewelry.com. If you can't make it into the store at 204 East Atlantic Avenue in Delray Beach. And you can call us always at 561-272-6654. Come and meet us.
Hi, thank you, Nicole. Welcome to the Seagate Hotel and Spa. I am William Sander, General Manager. The Seagate Hotel and Spa is located right here in Delray Beach. We have our famed Seagate Beach Club, which we offer a variety of water sports for our guests. We have our brand new Yacht Club facility featuring 44 slips, ranging from 40-foot sport fishers to housing 120-foot motor yachts. We have our private Seagate Country Club, which has a 7,103-yard championship golf course featuring 6 golf pros, including the famed Craig Harmon as our director of instructions. To learn more information about the property, please go to theseagatehotel.com.
The spa is a unique experience for anyone who comes in. You can spend the whole day here at the pool, in the tranquility room with our oversized eucalyptus steam rooms. You can have lunch, enjoy birthday parties, anniversaries. We offer champagne, wine. We always go above and beyond in getting the guests the best experience that we can offer them. One of my favorite offerings that we have in the spa is our hot shell massage. It's done with hot shells. We can get into certain areas with the shape of the shell. Locals love that. Thank you for joining us today. To book your appointment, you can go on our website, theseagatespa.com, give us a call, or just come on in.
Thank you for tuning in. I'm your host, Nicole Ruth, and I hope to see you next time as we discover more fabulous shopping destinations with We Boca TV. See you on the Ave.
Did you know that a healthy, beautiful smile is one of the keys to good overall health? New research shows that the health of your mouth reflects the health of your entire body. This includes whether or not you may be at risk of developing a chronic disease, such as heart disease, kidney disease, or oral cancer. Poor oral health may even cause some of these health problems to occur. Research also shows that good oral health can actually prevent certain diseases from developing.
Are you taking steps to ensure that you have a beautiful smile, like brushing at least twice a day with fluoride toothpaste, flossing, and scheduling regular dental cleanings? Good oral hygiene enhances your beautiful smile, and scheduling regular dental visits can help you prevent or even discover health problems at an early age.